Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA 5 video, we're going to be talking about the Diamond Casino and Resort, and if players will be able to sort of enter and go about it in a lone wolf style. Basically, will they be able to enjoy the casino stuff if they are by themselves? And this is actually something that I kind of overlooked on the really only Newswire post that Rockstar's put out so far regarding the Diamond Casino and Resort. And it's also prompted a lot of other discussion as well from Rockstar insiders and a bit more. So the line that got everyone talking and got the discussion going was this: whether you're having a night on the town with friends or seeking a brief solitary escape, the Diamond Casino and Resort is open to one and all. Okay, so I think that right there is good news for the lone wolf type of players. It seems as if, yes, you will be able to enter the casino all by yourself. You won't have to be a part of a group or a posse or part of a CEO or MC organization. And I also don't believe that you're going to have to be in a public session in order to go inside of it either. Now, just because you'll be able to go inside of the casino by yourself, and you will likely not have to be in a public session, does not necessarily mean that all the features of the casino will be available to you if you are either A, playing by yourself, or B, in a private session. So let's talk about the private session part first. Rockstar insider TezFunds2 has confirmed that there is going to be some sort of business attached with the Diamond Casino and Resort. Now, what sort of business that is, at this point, we're not too sure. But one thing that is for sure is that it will, like 99.9% most likely, have to be done in a public session. Even dating back to 2016, all the business opportunities that Rockstar have introduced have required you to be in a public session in order to start the sourcing and selling missions part of it. So I'm sure it will work very similar to the other businesses that we have in game, where you can enter your CEO office and you can enter your nightclub and you can enter your bunker, but as soon as you sit down at the computer or the hub or main operations, it's going to tell you, you know, you have to be in a public session in order to start this. You'll get that notification on the top left-hand corner of the screen. So that's the first thing I think you'll be limited in if you are playing in a private session. Now, what about some of the other things in the casino? I certainly think some things are going to be available even if you are completely by yourself. Like, let's just take a look at some of the things that Rockstar have said so far. They said it's going to feature lavish amenities. You know, what those lavish amenities are, we're not sure. I'm assuming that's going to be the suite or the VIP area that you buy into at the casino. You'll be able to probably take advantage of that by yourself. Same with the exclusive shopping. I'm sure you'll be able to do that by yourself. First class entertainment. I don't know what first class entertainment is going to be, whether that's shows or movies or things to do. I'm sure you can enjoy those by yourself as well. Rockstar talks about a state-of-the-art gaming facilities. I think this is different from the gambling games that we'll talk about in a bit. What those gaming facilities could be, I'm not entirely too sure at this point. And there's a couple of other things they talk about as well. The best-in-class concierge, valet parking, stuff like that. All of that looks like you can enjoy it by yourself if you're a lone wolf type of player. However, I do believe there will be some things that you will not be able to participate in by yourself. And I think a good bit of that has to do with the casino games, the table games that you'll be able to play. Because if it's anything like we see in Red Dead Online, it actually takes place with non-NPCs, with other characters. So in Red Dead Online right now, the only gambling game that we currently have is poker. Now, if you're unfamiliar with how things work in Red Dead Online, what basically happens is you go to one of five locations at any of the saloons, and what you'll see is a bunch of NPCs playing poker. And you'll have two options. You can start a private game, which will allow you to invite your friends, or you can join a public game, which will just pair you up with random people. The thing that's interesting here is there are no NPCs that you compete against. Everything is done competing against other players. So that's why I believe that at least some of the table games in GTA Online when the casino is updated will require you to interact with other players. You won't necessarily be able to be a lone wolf. Now, what sort of those table games will make you break out of your shell and play with other players? Well, I think the first one is pretty obvious. It's the one we see in Red Dead Online, and that is going to be a version of Texas Hold'em Poker. You cannot play that by yourself. Now, if Rockstar decides to add video poker into the game, which is what we saw in GTA San Andreas, then yes, you could technically play that by yourself. But if it's anything like what we see in Red Dead Online, it will require other players. Same with Blackjack. That's another rumored game mode that's supposed to be coming out in this update. That game mode will certainly require other players to compete against, again, unless it's some type of video format. So those are probably the two modes in which you will need other players to, I guess, sort of gamble against. But all the other ones can kind of be played by yourself. Like if you're doing a slot machine or roulette or spinning the lucky wheel. Or as I mentioned earlier, maybe Rockstar adds some sort of video gambling games like video poker, video blackjack. All of that will actually allow you to play by yourself. So it does look as if a good portion of this casino update will allow you to play as a lone wolf, which I know a lot of people are going to be looking forward to. Now, all of this discussion about having to eventually play with others in some situations and being able to be by yourself in others has generated a response from Rockstar insider Tez Funds 2, who ultimately said this. Well, I should say he responded to someone that says, "I don't know how you're doing it, but I never get anywhere near a full lobby. I'm lucky if I get four other people in an arena war game. The game should allow us to play against bots. Same with racers. I'd love to race against NPCs. It would make a lot of modes fun to play again for those who aren't obsessed with playing against other players all the time." And he says, "Matchmaking depends on your region first and then your connection quality in terms of how close you are to others. It's exactly like Call of Duty in the old days. Search for the closest players and then increase the search range. That's because GTA 5 and Grand Theft Auto Online is running on ancient code." So that's another thing to think of. I don't think we will be gambling against NPCs. I just don't think Rockstar is going to allow us to do that. Unless it's like an adversary mode or a contact mission, most things in Grand Theft Auto Online are PvP, not PvE. And also, Tez Funds 2 explains how it might match make you against other players when the casino DLC arrives. It's going to be your location first and then connection quality. Now, the final thing we're going to be discussing today is how Rockstar are going to handle the interior. So again, if you're a lone wolf and you're going in there by yourself, how are things going to work? And he says, if the casino requires you to access it via a loading screen, then the interior will be placed under the map. Not much different from an underground hotel. However, Rockstar use a trick with our apartments to make windows show what's outside, even though the interior may not be placed there. It's like every window is connected to a projector that simulates everything happening outside. If the casino interior is placed under the map, they may use this trick to show that it's not, but in reality, it really is. Now, sort of a follow-up to that, there's a little bit of a correction there. Someone responded to him saying, "Interiors with windows are inside the buildings they're supposed to be. You can use CodeWalker and see exactly where they're placed." And Tez Funds 2 said, "Sorry, you were right. It appears interiors with windows are placed inside. The trick is that they hide a piece of the interior to make it look like there's a window there." So this is interesting because with all of the other businesses that we have in game, especially the ones that are underground, like the bunkers and whatnot, it always loads the interior like under the map. Like it might be loaded underneath Mount Chiliad, or it might be loaded in underneath the Simeon docks. Well, with this case in the casino, because there's a giant resort attached to it and there's likely going to be a ton of windows, Rockstar might handle it like they do the apartments, where the inside of the casino might actually be inside of the building and not necessarily like underground in this sort of like random location halfway across the map. So I know we talked about a lot in this video today, but I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Number one, how are you going to go about the casino update? Are you going to be a lone wolf? Are you always going to play with friends and other random people? And are you going to be tackling this in public sessions or for the most part private or invite-only sessions? And how do you think the gambling games are going to work? Will we be forced to play with other players like what's happening in Red Dead Online? Or will Rockstar allow us to play either casino games where we can play by ourselves or against other NPCs? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And remember to subscribe if you guys are new and you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA 5 casino news. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be the first one to know when new information arrives. But as always, thank you guys all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.